Hi guys. So last week I was trying to create a dynamic liquid surface in Cinema 4D, something similar to dynamic paint in Blender, but we don't have that in Cinema 4D. So I tried something with the cloth engine to see if I could recreate something that looks kind of and moves like a liquid surface. And I posted the video above on Reddit and some of you guys asked how I made it, so it'd be easiest to just make a YouTube video and show you guys. So here we go. All right, so we're gonna start by creating a plane. Make it 100 by 100 centimeters, and in the segments I'm gonna put maybe 300 by 300 for now. If you want a more like detailed simulation later on, or some like finer ripples, you can always up this poly count. Add a cloth tag to the, because the whole simulation is driven by cloth, which is why it runs almost real time depending on your poly count. And the cloth settings and surface, let's put the bendiness on 0 and the mask on something small like 0.01. And in the mix animation tab, you want to turn on force, width force, and put it on something like 1. And then you want to make sure if you hit Control D, you go to the project settings. And in the scene tab, under simulation, just put the gravity to 0, because we don't want any default gravity in the scene, because we are going to create our own gravity. So hit Shift C, gravity, there we go. And then in this gravity, in the fields tab, let's create a linear field. I'm going to make this 1 centimeter, rotate it 90 degrees so the fall off is pointing up. And then I'm just going to go into the side view here and just grab this linear field and move it so it's just above the surface of the plane. And just leave this gravity on the default settings, and then copy the gravity and rotate it 180 degrees. So basically this new gravity is going to be pointing up and the other gravity is pointing down, but the one pointing down only affects everything above the plane, and the one pointing up only affects everything below the plane. So the one on top kind of acts as gravity, keeping everything down, and the one below kind of acts as a surface tension. So to make sure like everything, well, the plane basically is caught in between these two forces. And that's basically it for the setup. I'm just going to add a reflective material to this plane so you can see what's going on a little bit better. And I'm going to make a sphere to demonstrate the effect of the surface. A collider tag. Yeah. Let's press play and see what happens. Okay, that's not what's supposed to happen. I think it was just because my timeline wasn't on 0. So yeah, that looks fine. And yeah, you can see it's working like it's supposed to. So yeah, then one more thing I did, just to break up the waves a little bit, is add a very light turbulence to the scene. So yeah, let's maybe put this on 0.01 and the scale on 10%. And I'm going to put this on aerodynamics wind. Play this again. Okay, it's very subtle, but there's some minimal movement on the surface now. And okay, let me move this down. is going to break up the waves just a little bit. Yep. You can, if you want, you can, it's going to depend on your hardware, but if you up this polycan, the ripples are going to be a little bit finer and more detailed. So, but obviously it's going to run slower. Yeah, you can see it's not real time anymore. I'm recording as well, so but you can see these ripples are actually really nice, really fine. And you can use this for a lot of different things. Like, for instance, I tried something here. Hold on. With it's just a basic emitter, and I have some spheres in there, like very small ones, as collider bodies. And you can see, you can create some kind of rain. Or if you want to have something below the surface, like for instance, a crocodile swimming there or something, you could just put it below the surface as well, and it works just the same way. Hold on, let me restart. So yeah, it's a pretty cool effect. Very simple. And runs almost real time, depending on your polycam, of course. There you go, guys. Simple as that.